Hello, I'm Zoompad, and I want to talk about child abuse and the effect it has on people. Because I was abused as a child, and I was put into Chadswell Assessment Centre as a place of safety, and it wasn't safe. It was being run by some very wicked people, and so I was re-abused, and all through my life I've been vulnerable to abuse, because once you've been abused you don't react in the same way that people who haven't been abused react. You have you develop coping mechanisms. One of the things that I used to do when I felt as though I was going to be abused was to freeze. I would sort of cut myself off. It was as though I was trying to cut my body off from my feelings, and so I would not feel the pain of abuse, and it's a bit like how rabbits behave when something goes towards them, and they sort of freeze up, or hedgehogs, they sort of curl into their shell. And I used to do that as well, which wasn't really a good idea, because you know, that's a dangerous thing to do. But you just cope as well. You just develop these coping mechanisms. I suffered almost 4 decades of depression, and people used to laugh at me, and I'm sorry to say this, but people are not always very kind when people are crying, when other people are crying. And they can be quite unkind. Not everyone, obviously. I think I've met some angels in my life that have been very, very kind to me. But a lot of people, if they see that you're upset, they don't know what to do. I think they feel frightened of somebody that's crying. I don't know what it is. And then there are other people that will think it's great, and they will call you a nutter, and that's what's happened to me. I've been called the town nutter, which is not nice, and you know that people are calling you that, but what can you do about it? You could get aggressive, I suppose, but what's the point in that? You can't do anything about it, and so you just bury the pain. It's just one continuous session of burying pain, basically. I hated it. I felt so depressed, but I just used to wonder, why was I born there? And I'm a Christian, so I do believe in God. I had a very, very dramatic conversion, they call it, to being a Christian. It was extremely dramatic, and there was no way that I could doubt that Jesus Christ is alive, because of the way I became a Christian. But I did doubt that he loved me, and I felt worthless for most of my life. It's making me well up thinking about this, but I am going to talk about it, because I want to use the pain to reach out to other people, so that other people can be healed. Other people that have been depressed for a long time. All that pain must have been for some reason. I think that we do go on this journey, and I don't understand it. I don't think anybody does. But I know that Jesus is there, and Jesus has healed me of so many things. So he's lifted me from that very, very depressed spot, and given me hope. And I don't feel as though I'm walking through a long black tunnel anymore, because I used to wake up feeling as though life was just bleak and dark. I don't feel like that anymore. So I'm living proof that a person that has suffered serious abuse and re-abuse, that they can be healed, that they can be lifted. And you can't do it for yourself. I don't think you can. I really don't. You can help yourself so much, but I don't know. I don't think that we can. I don't think we can do without God. Anyway, I'm going to just read this little tiny bit of my favourite book, because I keep getting drawn to this passage in the Bible, and I just find it so beautiful, because I feel as though we're living in a very special time. There are a lot of people coming forward that have been abused, and they are coming out. They're realising that they have been abused, and they're sort of reaching out for something better. And I'm drawn to this passage. It's Isaiah chapter 60. Arise, shine, for your light has come, and the glory of the Lord rises upon you. See, darkness covers the earth, and thick darkness is over the peoples. But the Lord rises upon you, and his glory appears over you. Nations will come to your light, and kings to the brightness of your dawn. I just find that so beautiful, and I believe it. I just think that there is something very, very special happening in this time, and I'm a person that's been through so much abuse, but I feel like a privileged person because of the time that we're living in.